This video is an overview of Filmage Screen, an all-in-one video screen recorder that integrates a screen recorder with video editing tools, plus an audio recorder and a built-in video converter. It can record a full screen or a custom area, or you can dial in a particular aspect ratio like 16:9. You can choose different resolutions up to 4K. The video editor has basic editing tools, plus you can add text and drawing tools as well as change color. It has the ability to add extra audio tracks for music and voiceover, as well as multiple tracks for the text and the drawing tools. Filmage is easily understandable with exclusive features like the ability to record the screen of your iPhone, ideal for tutorials on how to use the iPhone. And for those wondering, this recording is shown with Filmage Screen running on Mac OS 11. Big Sur. I'm Bruce McBride, and I can provide one-on-one training over the internet in Final Cut Pro and in iMovie. So just click the link below, and I can help you with your projects or learning from scratch. After you've installed Filmage Screen, when you first launch the app, the software will open the system preferences on your Mac with security and privacy selected. You'll need to authorize camera, also microphone, and files and folders should have Filmage Screen able to select removable volumes. Also check that screen recording has Filmage Screen selected. To do this one, you'll need to unlock the padlock to make those changes. When you now launch Filmage, the selection window appears. Here you can start screen recording, web camera, you can record from your iPhone, and you can also do an audio only recording. There's a video editor and a video converter. In the menu bar, you have the same options. We'll have a look at how to set up your preferences. Under the general, you can change the 3-second countdown, and you can show your cursor, and you can save the video to a certain location, and also the audio recordings to a location on your computer. Under the shortcuts, you can turn those on and off, and these are the pause, that's command 1, and the stop recording, command 2. We'll start a screen recording, so clicking on screen here, we can then now select the screen. You can see the blue outline there, and if you click on a window, let's click on this window here, it will record that window even though this one is overlapping it and you won't see the overlapping window. Or you can select an area that you want on the screen yourself, and then by selecting here, you can ask for a 1920 by 1080 image. The resolution can be selected as well, and you can go up to 4K, and you can also go up to 60 frames per second. In these selections down here, this will take you back to files that have already been created. This will bring up your shortcuts. And this is a timer or scheduler. And finally, in the settings, you can turn your webcam on so that it will show in any location that you want to put it in the screen. So we'll just start that off recording. And while you're recording, you can move that to any position so it's not hiding things in your tutorial. You can also select just the system audio or your external microphone, or you can select both the system audio and your external microphone, and you can choose which microphone you want to use. When you're selecting the system audio with microphone, they're both recorded to the same channel, and it would be nice to be able to separate them in the editor. There is the ability to have several tracks of audio in the editor, but it doesn't seem to let you select or separate the system sound from the microphone. And we'll have a look at the video editor a little later. Otherwise, it'd be nice to have some sort of ducking feature that you could select before you start recording so that you could either duck the system audio or the microphone audio. I like to film a screen area 16:9, and that allows me to record part of the screen while I have my script visible but not showing in the recording. It's a pity the screen is locked to Filmage while you're waiting to start recording. And once you set that error, you can't move anything else on the screen because Filmage has locked the screen until you start recording. And then once you start recording, it will then go through its 3-second start, and then you can move windows around as you wish and select items on the screen, but not before actual recording. I did a previous review on the Movavi Screen Recorder. It allows the other applications to be accessed before the recorder is started. It would be nice to have this added to Filmage, though the features in Filmage certainly outnumber those in the Movavi Screen Recorder. I'm going to start a screen recording with Filmage now, and we will press the red button to start the recording. Imagine that this is a tutorial where we're skimming through, we're looking at the color correction in the inspector, we're selecting a clip in the browser, and let's drag a cross dissolve in here. And then let's just assume that that's our edit for now. We can stop the recording by clicking the red button here. And when you stop the recording, you get the latest file showing in the file list, and that's this one here. And if we wanted to put that into Final Cut, we can click on the file list here. We can see that that pops up in the Finder, and we can simply drag that file into Final Cut, and then it's there for us to edit. We could then bring that into our Final Cut timeline. And there's the file we've just recorded. Let's just play it now. Imagine that this is a tutorial where we're skimming through, we're looking at the color correction in the inspector. If you wanted to edit that file in the Filmage video editor, then click the scissors here, and that brings it up in the video editor. And we can add some text. So let's add some text that flies in from the left-hand side. So let's just type hello. And as we play through now, you can see that that comes in from the left. If you put one on the right, then we can enter that text here and play that through from here. And you'll see that slides in from the right-hand side. And notice that each time you add an effect or some video graphic effect, it creates a new track in the timeline. We can also add a graphic. You can add arrows. And again, you can see that that adds its own video track. And we can simply add a music track by selecting the Add Music, going to the Finder and finding an audio track and then opening that. That brings it in here. And then all we need to do is to place the playhead where we want that to come in and add it in. And we can also do the same thing by adding a voiceover. So starting the voiceover here, and it's going to add the words that I'm just saying, and now I've stopped that, and you can see that that's been added in there. If you wanted to add a further voiceover from here, then you can add that voiceover. This is what I'm saying. Stop the voiceover, and you'll see that it's created another audio track there for you. The other way of doing this is to put your playhead where you want it to be, and then right-clicking, and you can add video, add images, or add audio with a right-click on the mouse. Once you've completed your edit in the video editor, then you can come to the share and selecting Apple ProRes, for instance, if we're sending it to Final Cut, and then we can export that out and have the edited file go to Final Cut as a ProRes file. Finally, let's look at the unique ability to record the screen on your iPhone or iPad so that you can create tutorials for apps on your mobile devices. You can attach the iPhone by a lightning cable or with AirPlay. When the remote device is connected, you'll see a green dot beside the iOS icon and the name of the device will appear. Here we can see it's an iPhone XR. When you click on the icon, the remote screen will show and it will start recording when you press the red button. Here's the home screen of the iPhone. I've touched the settings icon, close that, touch the App Store icon, close that. Press the camera icon. And now back to the home screen. There are two versions of Filmage Screen, a free version that is time sensitive, and the pro version that includes all features at US $29.99, 50% off for Black Friday sales. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please like, subscribe, and press the bell so you'll be notified of new videos uploaded every Sunday.